Department of Health or DOH is currently addressing public concern regarding circulating information on social media that mpox virus allegedly comes from the COVID-19 vaccine, specifically AstraZeneca. This clarification comes after Senator Rafi Tulpo asked Health Assistant Secretary and spokesperson Albert Domingo if there is any basis for this information.
Correct me if I'm wrong or correct this information na kumakalat ngayon sa social media. Isa rin sa pinagmulan nito dahil yung content ng isang vaccine ang nagmumula rin dito, AstraZeneca particularly. Is that true? Is it true?
Ito po ay hindi totoo, Mr. Senator. Maraming salamat po na raise niyo po for correction, no? Pero hindi po siya galing sa any vaccine, more especially dun sa mga COVID-19 vaccines po. They continue to be safe and reliable.
So mali yung impormasyon na kumakalat sa social media na meron kasing halo doon sa mpox, sa AstraZeneca. Kaya maraming kinakabane, uy, nagpa-vaccine ako AstraZeneca. Kinakabane marami sa atin. So that's not true.
That's not true, Mr. Chair. I can even give my personal assurance because my primary series was AstraZeneca.
Very good.
Domingo also emphasized that mpox virus was discovered in 1958 and was first detected in human from monkey in 1970s, so that mpox are not from any COVID-19 vaccine. The spokesperson also reiterated that mpox and COVID-19 are distinct.
Malaki ho ang pagkakaiba, Mr. Chair, ng mpox sa COVID-19. Ang COVID-19 ay airborne, mabilis pong makahawa. Ang mpox ay close physical intimate contact, dikit-dikit po. Halimbawa po ay magkatabi kami ng aking seatmate dito, hindi ho siya makakuha ng mpox kung ako po ay meron, kung hindi naman ho kami magdidikit ng braso or kung hindi kami magaharap-harapan. Hindi ho tulad nung ating COVID-19 na kahit yung dalawang tao na malayo sa akin at humangin lang po ay pwedeng pumunta sa kanya yung mpox.
Currently, Health Department continues its surveillance efforts, particularly at the country's seaports and airports, to prevent the entry of clade 1 of mpox, that much more dangerous than clade 2, which has a less than 1% fatality rate and is not severe. This is the strain detected in the Philippines from a 33-year-old man recently from the NCR. However, there are no strict travel restrictions imposed in the country unless a traveler comes from mpox hotspot country and may be carrying clade 1 of the virus. Meanwhile, since mpox is usually transmitted through a droplet infection, close contact and intimate contact, ASEC Domingo stated that while wearing a face mask is not necessary, it can still provide added protection, especially in crowded places where people are in close proximity.
Ang face mask po, kung napakadikit talaga, for example, nag-commute or maliit na elevator, kasi po pag sobrang lapit na, pwedeng magkaroon siya ng droplet infection na sinasabi.
Droplet.
Opo. Pero hindi po siya yung tipong magkalayo ho tayo, tas yung aircon ho ay bumuga na nakita natin sa COVID-19. Hindi po siya ganun.
Okay.
It is worth noting that the first case of monkeypox or mpox in the Philippines was recorded in July 2022. As of 2024, the country has reported 10 cases, with 9 recovered and 1 remaining active, which the DOH is closely monitoring. In Africa, where an outbreak of mpox, clade 1B strain recorded with a 10% fatality rate. Most of those who have died are HIV positive, immunocompromised, elderly, or very young. This is Vanessa Cleofas for EuroTV News.